People rejoice and all nations listen. Christ God is risen, let us rejoice. Dance all ye stars and sing all ye mountains. Christ God is risen, let us rejoice. Whisper ye woods and blow all ye winds. Christ God is risen, let us rejoice. O seas, proclaim and roar all ye bees. Christ God is risen, let us rejoice.
Zbog čega je čoveku potrebna religija? Ovo pita otac pravoslavlja u Americi, prepodobni Serafim Rose, na početku svog čuvenog predavanja održanog studentima na Univerzitetu Kalifornija 1981. godine. Odgovor koji on tada dao glasi: postoji mnogo različitih razloga zbog kojih se čovek bavi religijom, ali postoji samo jedan razlog ako je čovek zaista ozbiljan, a to je, jednom rečju, zato da bi došao u kontakt sa realnošću.
Ring all ye bells, let everyone hear. Christ God is risen, let us rejoice.
Serafim Rose dalje objašnjava da se naša takozvana svakodnevna realnost brzo menja, truli i nestaje, ne ostavljajući ništa iza sebe i ne nudeći nikakvu trajniju sreću ljudskoj duši. Dublje ispod ovakve realnosti mora da postoji nekakva postojana realnost. To je osjećaj koji je urođen svakom čoveku.
Glory to thee, God Almighty, Christ God is risen, let us rejoice.
Samo godinu dana nakon ovog predavanja Serafim Rose se upokojio u manastiru koji je osnovao uz duhovnu pomoć Svetog Jovana Šangajskog. Osim manastirskog bratstva koje čine rođeni Amerikanci, iza sebe je ostavio i kapitalno pisano delo, i danas delimično u rukopisima i još ne do kraja objavljeno. Početkom ovog milenijuma knjige Serafima Rosea, one koje je do sada štampao njegov manastir u Kaliforniji, pronalaze brojne i oduševljene čitaoce u svim evropskim pravoslavnim zemljama. Kako su te knjige tako brzo i masovno stizale i bivale prevođene u Rumuniji, Rusiji, Srbiji ili Grčkoj, pitali smo jeromonaha Damaskina, koji je u Rouzovom manastiru zadužen za uređivanje i objavljivanje njegovih rukopisa. Otac Damaskin kaže da je impresioniran, ali da odgovor ne zna. Bio je iznenađen koliko je delo Serafima Rosea danas poznato u Rusiji, na primjer. Rekao nam je i da je na svojim putovanjima po pravoslavnim zemljama Evrope viđao u nekim manastirima Serafima Rosea već odslikanog kao sveca. Ove godine ponovo smo posjetili manastir prepodobnog Serafima Rosea posvećen svetom Germanu sa Aljaske, manastir koji je danas pod okriljem Srpske pravoslavne crkve. Monasi su nas odveli do skita Svete Ksenije, u kome je desetak monahinja, Amerikanki, koje se u divljim šumama u nacionalnom prirodnom rezervatu na severu Kalifornije, u svom skromnom manastiru, kao revnosne monahinje Srpske pravoslavne crkve, mole za Srbiju i Srbe.
Because, you know, none of us speak Serbian, although a lot of Serbs now speak English, but we don't have any direct contacts. Just through the monks, whoever they bring to us.
Yeah.
So, do
you know anything about Serbia? Yeah.
I think I probably know maybe a little more than the average American, because we're in the Serbian church. And also, I have a lot of contacts with Russians, and we've met a lot of Serbians. So
we have so much to learn from you, because the ultimate thing is to be thankful to God for all that He brings to us each day and each situation. And I know that the people of Serbia have truly, because of everything that has happened to them through the years of war, Turkish rule, etc., and having kept the faith through all of this, that you have gained something that we can learn from, and we hope to be able to visit there at some point. Some of the nuns of the Skeet, we'd like to meet some of you and see your holy places, and we invite you, if you are ever in our country, to please come to our little Skeet. We would like to meet you, to pray with you.
Can you give some message to people in Belgrade?
To people in Belgrade? Well, I think I can probably say on the behalf of the sisters that we would thank you. Thank you very much for taking our monastery into the Serbian church under your protection. And that we are very happy to have the protection of the Serbian church, and we very much respect all of our Serbian bishops, and especially we respect Patriarch Pavle, and we know him, we've heard so much about him and know him to be such a holy man, and so we ask for everyone's prayers for our small monastery here, and in turn we always keep Serbia, suffering Serbia, in our prayers too.
Pre odlaska u ženski skit Svete Ksenije, vaš izveštač proveo je nekoliko dana u manastiru Svetog Germana Aljaškog i razgovarao sa igumanom jeromonahom Gerasimom. Ovaj razgovor je snimljen 10 kilometara od manastira, u stvari, u selu Platina, u manastirskoj kancelariji gde se nalazi nekoliko kompjutera, telefonskih linija i fax mašina. U ovom komunikacionom centru manastira prepodne dežura ili radi nekoliko monaha koji prevode knjige i bave se sličnim poslovima. A ovde ima i struje i tekuće vode, za razliku od manastira na vrhu obližnje planine, koji je van dometa čak i bilo koje mobilne telefonske mreže.
Well, what I remember when I first came to the monastery to visit back in 1980, and we heard there was a monastery there. In fact, someone told us that if we went to that monastery to visit, we would be chased away with guns. I never saw such a thing happen. We came to the monastery. This was 26, 27 years ago. And it was a hot, dusty road. It was the middle of beginning of July. We arrived on the eve of the feast of the Nativity of St. John the Baptist. The monastery, of course, is there's dirt all over. It's clay. We don't have pavement. We don't have blacktop. We don't have cement. And in those days, we had an old wooden church. And there were very few gardens. The gardens were enclosed in a fence to keep them away from the deer. So we didn't see a lot of flowers around. Some of the buildings had cobwebs all over. And it was very different. I didn't grow up like that. It was very hot and dry. There was one place where you could pump water, and another place where there was a little faucet where you could wash your hands. And that was it. And of course, there wasn't any indoor plumbing. and there was electricity only when the generator ran, but usually, as was the case for many years afterwards, the generator was usually broken. But nonetheless, I thought, this is how monks lived in the Egyptian desert. This is how monks lived on Mount Athos originally. This obviously was how monks lived in the far Russian north. And I didn't know too much about Serbia, so I couldn't really say, but I'm sure in the Middle Ages perhaps it was like that. I came back to the monastery again the next year and stayed. And now, of course, we have an office down here where we're recording this right now. And of course, we have a telephone here and some computers. But the monastery, we don't have a telephone. And it's wonderful that during church services, we don't hear a telephone ringing. In fact, if people bring cell telephones, they won't ring during the church services either. We don't have to tell people to turn their cell telephones off because there's no reception at the monastery. We're too far away. And we don't have electricity, except we have a generator that we can run to pump water or to charge up some batteries or to run a couple electrical tools. And we also have a couple of solar panels to provide solar energy for a few lights for some work. But since we don't print at the monastery anymore, all the printing is done outside of the monastery, then there is less need for the electricity. It's something that people in our day and age feel that it's impossible to live without.
When our Lord was baptized in the River Jordan, on that bright day before all the people, the heavens on high became wide open, and the angels drew near to the water. At once St. John was filled with fear.
Mesto Platina ima 60 stanovnika, mada mi otac Spajsije uz osmeh kaže da su to sigurno preterivanja. On smatra da u Platini živi manje ljudi i da će ih manastir po broju stanovnika sigurno vrlo brzo nadmašiti. Sada u manastiru živi 15 monaha, nekoliko iskušenika i uvek nekoliko gostiju.
And when our Lord rose up from it, a strange voice was heard from heaven.
Ova nešto duža zgrada ceo je, kako se kaže, downtown Platine. U njoj su jedna kafanica, jedna prodavnica i pošta. Prva najbliža banka, na primer, nalazi se u mestu Reading, koje je udaljeno 40 milja ili 65 kilometara od Platine. Ova mala pošta praktično opslužuje samo manastir i dva puta je razmišljano o njenom zatvaranju. Mesto od 50-ak stanovnika ne treba pošta, ali pošta opstaje jer je poštanski promet koji pravi manastir sasvim dovoljan za njeno postojanje. Preko ove male pošte monasi uglavnom šalju u svet svoje knjige, od čega se manastir i izdržava i što je jedini redovni prihod za život monaha.
How many books you publish in a year? Last year,
every year is different. We're usually behind schedule. This year we published two books. The first book that we published this last year is called The Lives of the Georgian Saints. This was translated from Georgian into English by a friend of ours, Elizabeth Ninoshvili, and her husband, David Ninoshvili, from Georgian into English, and they asked us to print it. They asked us to print it 4 years ago. It took us 4 years to edit the book, to include supplementary material, to do research, to design the cover, to acquire the illustrations. The whole book is illustrated. It's the first time that we've done a full-color book and of this quality. And it's 500 pages, so it took us a long time to prepare. And then this December, just before the new year, we printed another book. This is a United States printing of a book that was previously printed in English in Great Britain, We Shall See Him as He Is. It's the writings, autobiographical writings of Archimandrite Sophroni Sakharov, the disciple of St. Silouan of Mount Athos. And then every year as well, we print the annual St. Herman calendar. This is a new calendar for 2007. This is the Julian calendar as used by the Serbian Orthodox Church. And each year we have a feature article. This year the feature article is about the saints of southern Italy. Many years ago I had received a book about the saints, the Byzantine saints of southern Italy. It was published in Thessaloniki in English. It was the doctoral dissertation of a professor. And then we had some friends last year who made a pilgrimage to southern Italy, to the old Orthodox shrines, the holy places of southern Italy, which are not very well known outside of Greece. And so we decided to present them, and we also entered into the calendar some new saints from Italy and Sicily who are actually already commemorated by the Greek Orthodox Church, but are not very well known. So those are the three publications that we did this year.
What are the circulation of these books?
We usually print, for the initial print run, about 3,000 copies. For our St. Herman calendar, we print about 4,000 copies annually. Sometimes if we know a book is going to sell really well, we'll print more, 4,000 or 5,000. But in the United States, up until now, that's been about the limit of our ability to distribute a book. And as you know, we don't have a lot of facilities for just holding or warehousing books.
Are people helping you? I mean, sending you some help in money and in anything, as they do for monasteries?
Yes. Well, primarily our income comes from the sale of our books. But we do also have some friends that help us out, usually around Nativity, Božić, or around Pascha. Mm-hmm. We'll get some more additional funding that comes irregularly. Just happens. Yeah. And there's no consistency. Except around Božić, we usually receive a little bit more. But we try to depend on what we can produce with our own publications, so that we are not basically, as the fathers would say, eating from other man's labors. That someone else works and we eat from what they produce. So we try to use the money that comes in to print more books, to put it back into our publications. So because part of that, again, is that's connected to our missionary work. The ideal of St. Herman of Alaska, who came to the United States to proclaim the Orthodox faith.
Oh, the Archangel of God, Michael the Commander, the sword-bearing servant of the Lord Most High, the sword-bearing servant of the Lord Most High. He stands before the Lord, with the heavenly hosts, with the mighty angels and the holy souls.
Kada sam igumana Gerasima upitao kako je moguće da čovek rođen u Americi u veku komfora i tehnologije živi u manastiru u kome nema telefona, struje i tekuće vode, odgovorio mi je da ga čudi da jedno takvo pitanje postavlja Beograđanin.
Well, I think the people of Belgrade in 1999, no, that's not necessarily true. They didn't die when their electricity was turned off. And in fact, maybe they became closer together. In the evening, for example, when it's dark, after our prayers are over, the monks go to their cells. And because we don't have electricity, they go to bed earlier, and they arise early in the morning, usually about a little after 4 o'clock in the morning. And so we don't necessarily miss the electricity, the telephones, this and that. All these things are good when used properly. And in our office, of course, we have use of them for the purposes of our publications. And our monastery supports itself by means of our publications. We sell books, our annual calendar, and our magazine. And that is how we support ourselves. So we are able to live in our desert by the works of our publications.
Let us lift up our eyes to
U manastiru Svetog Germana Aljaškog gost je bio i jeromonah Jovan iz manastira Tvrdoš u Hercegovini, koji je sada jedan od pomoćnika novopostavljenog vladike zapadnoameričkog gospodina Maksima, čije je sedište u Los Angelesu. Otec Jovan Tvrdoški, visok, inteligentan, blage naravi, stigao je u Ameriku prvi put u životu pre nedelju dana i tek je počeo da uči engleski. Međutim, sa igumanom Gerasimom komunicira bez smetnji, pa sam ih viđao kako šetaju okolinom i raspravljaju o liturgijskim i sličnim pitanjima. Otac Jovan, koji dolazi iz strogog manastira u Hercegovini u kome žive dvojica srpskih vladika, rekao mi je da je impresioniran monaškom revnošću koja vlada u ovom američkom manastiru. Prota Dušan Bunjević, jedan od najstarijih i najuglednijih pravoslavnih srpskih sveštenika u Americi, kaže da su konvertiti u pravoslavnu veru po pravilu i najbolji i najčvršći pravoslavni vernici. Oni su bolji od nas, zaključuje Prota Bunjević.
Letters from Belgrade, from ordinary people, not from monks or bishops, and would you like to have a better connections with them by internet or by...
We, actually at the present time, we have begun to receive letters from Serbia, Belgrade, Montenegro, etc., both by email and by letter post, also delivered by hand. Last year, we had a wonderful man staying with us, Vladimir Muricic, who has been in England for a number of years. He has undertaken to edit the translation of Saint Eustine Popovich's Orthodox Dogmatic Theology. And so this year he traveled to Chilia Monastery to arrange and ask the blessing of the Igumania there. Yeah. And in November, we received a letter with the blessing to proceed on the translation.
Glykeria is her name. I remember.
Yes, exactly. And also that she would forward this letter to the spiritual children of Father Eustine. I assume that's Father Artemia, Bishop Artemia, Bishop Athanasia, and others, and Bishop Metropolitan Amphilochia, who evidently have the rights to his publications or approve the publication of his writings in other languages. So that's still going on, and Vladimir Muricic will return in March to our monastery. Now, we have a difficulty in replying to letters in the Serbian language. Usually we can find someone to help us translate.
Yeah.
And because there's no one in the monastery at the moment who can write in Serbian. We can usually figure it out, read it, make sense of it, but we can't necessarily reply back.
Yeah, yeah. So if someone is writing you, please to write to you in English.
If they can. If they can't, we'll find a way.
Do you know who loves you so?
Prevod ohridskog prologa Vladike Nikolaja na engleski u izdanju manastira Svetog Germana Aljaškog 2002. godine jedna je od knjiga koju viđate najčešće u svim kućama američkih Srba. Vrlo je zanimljivo koliko mnogo srpskih knjiga prevode na engleski ovi monasi i njihovi prijatelji, pa ovaj mali manastir na planini Safford, pored Seoceta Platina, svakako je bez premca svetski centar prevođenja srpske duhovne i crkvene literature na engleski jezik. Preko manastira mnogo toga stiglo je do američkih medija i javnosti, kao što je i vest o utamničenju vladike Jovana u Makedoniji. Za vladiku Jovana manastir se posebno moli na svim liturgijama.
But far as I know, you haven't been to Serbia, have you?
Not yet.
Never.
Not yet.
Do you have any wish list? Where would you like to go? What would you like to see? Whom to meet? What to experience?
Well, that presents a big problem. The big problem is when our former bishop, Bishop Jovan, now Bishop of Shimadia Diocese, when I asked to go someplace, he said, for 2 weeks. In other words, the abbot should not be gone from the monastery. The abbot doesn't run away from the monastery. And so I've always remembered that. So you could say, he taught me well. I know in my conscience that I'm not supposed to be gone for long. So the problem is that there are so many wonderful places in Serbia, including the Šumadija Diocese, Kragujevac, etc., where I could not think of going to Serbia without, for example, going to see our Vladika Jovan. It would be impossible. And so there's also the great holy places. I would want to visit them all. And there are other places which I should see, especially the smaller monasteries where the daily monastic life is lived. Because as a monk, that should be the most important thing to me, how my monastic brothers are living in Serbia, Srpska Republika, Kosovo, everything. Mm-hmm. And of course, to keep that contact close with those with whom we already have a spiritual relationship or who have visited us, mm-hmm. like Episcop Grigoria and the monks of Tverdos and the monks of Sopočani and the monks from Kosovo, where we already have some contact. And how could someone do that in 2 weeks? So, and so you could say, if I went and only had 2 weeks, I would feel very sad. And if I didn't go at all, I would be even more sad.
What you know about my hometown, Belgrade, and do you have any wish list if we talk about Belgrade?
I know so little. It's a huge city. We had a wonderful young man here many years ago, Borislav. Borislav visited us, and later he went to seminary in Belgrade. And I remember it was during the time of the bombing when he visited us. And he told us how he wanted to make movies and how he had taken pictures of all the bridges in Belgrade. So he had all this video footage of the bridges that were bombed.
He showed that to you here?
No, he told me about it. And he told me he wanted to make a movie. He wanted to had a story he wanted to tell. I think that was at a time he was awakening spiritually. And so now he went to seminary. I don't know. Maybe he will be a bishop. I don't know. And so as someone like him who began to share with me about his city, his hometown, and of course the Sveti Sava Church on Vračar and all sorts of things. And
Patriarch Pavle lives in Belgrade, for example.
Exactly. And so in a way, also, there's so much there. There's 2,000 years of history in Belgrade or more, and there's the ancient cities along the Danube. And for an Orthodox Christian, it's all fascinating. Yeah. Orthodox Christian, everything from the sites of like the Nazi reprisals, Jasenovac, the monasteries, the cradles of civilization, Miloševo, all these places. It's hard to know where to start.
Yeah.
And then in Belgrade, for example, where the theological faculty is, you have young people who are studying the Orthodox faith, studying theology. And I know that, for example, there, I would find people who feel exactly as I did when I began the to live the monastic life.
You know why? Because they read in Belgrade very much Father Serafim Rose's books and his thoughts.
And so, you know, maybe I would find right there people who would be lifelong friends. And I would also want to see, I'd also want to see some of the sites of the 1999 bombing. So I have it in my mind. This is what happened. This is what happens when you have unlimited power and no accountability on both sides. This is what happens. It ends up this destruction.
Who with rays of his spirit enlightens you and me? Who with rays of his spirit enlightens?
Jednu zanimljivu priču čuo sam od monaha Nikolaja, nekada njujorškog umetnika, danas stanovnika minijaturne kelije prepune retkih pravoslavnih knjiga iz svih krajeva sveta. Njegova kelija je u zidinama koje okružuju portu kao mala kula na manastirskoj kapiji. Otac Nikolaj prevodi sa nekoliko jezika, vrstan je stručnjak za staroslovenski jezik. Odmah nakon što je manastir Svetog Germana primljen u okrilje Srpske pravoslavne crkve, telefonom se javio predstavnik velike zajednice Srba negde u unutrašnjosti Amerike. Rekao je da je saznao da Srbi imaju jedan lep manastir na severu Kalifornije i da moli nekog od monaha tog manastira da za sledeći Vidovdan bude gost i održi im predavanje o kosovskom boju. Poziv je naravno prihvaćen, ali pošto su svi stanovnici manastira rođeni Amerikanci, niko u manastiru tada nije imao pojma o kosovskoj bici, niti ko je car Lazar. Narednih meseci, sve do Vidovdana, otac Nikolaj čitao je samo o kosovskom boju i caru Lazaru, sve što je mogao da pronađe, i uspeo je na kraju da srpskim Amerikancima održi predavanje koje se pamti. Usput, on je preveo na engleski knjigu vladike Nikolaja o kosovskoj žrtvi i još neka dela iz ove oblasti. Zahvaljujući prevodima oca Nikolaja, manastir od tog vremena svakog 28. juna služi parastos kosovskim vitezovima i svima koji su postradali za veru i otačestvo, za krst časni i slobodu zlatnu. Inače, otac Nikolaj poznat je među bratijom i po tome što ne voli da se fotografiše. Jedina njegova fotografija koja za sada postoji, baš zato istaknuta je na oglasnoj tabli u manastirskoj kancelariji.
I think no one ever had prayed on these places in Belgrade that were bombed. Will you if you come?
Yes, yes. It's very interesting. You know, for example, when we heard, we had some sort of message, or maybe it was an email, that a German ambassador was in Kragujevac with Bishop Jovan when they had the anniversary of the Nazi reprisals. And that's something. That's amazing. Things change. And, you know, so much history has gone through. World War II. We have this United States, of course, they have great honor for General Draža Mihailović, who, interestingly, he was killed, executed, on the same day as the Russian Tsar Nicholas. It's the same day. And history, very few people know about him outside, other than Serbs. Here's a person who was, all the guilt for everything possible was pinned on him. He was made to look like like a scapegoat. Just like in the Old Testament, you have a scapegoat. And here's a person who is a hero. And in the United States, he's been, among the Serbs, he's been celebrated as a hero. And they were able to do the same thing in Serbia during the communist period. You couldn't do that. And so Serbia, even, you know, contemporary, modern Serbian culture is also part of the mission of our church, the young priests, the young seminarians come from the midst of that. And that's also where famous, you know, the famous Orthodox writers have written, and artists and iconographers, even the workshops now producing iconostasis and icons and things. And so this is the center of the Serbian Orthodox culture. So it's actually very important. So someday, when the right time comes, I will go.
Mighty bells gently resound, heralding the dearest voice. With the angels from the humble, Christ now calls us to himself. With the angels from the humble, Christ now calls us to himself. Тихо звучна звона, являючи мій оглас, уставу пой сам вона, Христос себе зове нас, уставу пой сам вона, Христос себе зове нас. The bright heavens gloriously shine, hosts of angels gather in love, praising our sweetest Jesus, they fill heaven with their song. Praising our sweetest Jesus, they fill heaven with their song. Milo nebo slavom blista, angeli su svili hor, se proslavlja Boga Hrista sa se hori rajski dvor. Se proslavlja Boga Hrista sa se hori rajski dvor.
Would you like to come to Serbia one day?
Of course, sure. I'd love to go to Serbia. Mm-hmm. Yeah.